As you know, that data can be arranged in two ways. One is group data and second is ungrouped data. In the ungrouped data, we have individual series. That means individual items are given and the frequency is not given. And in the group data, we have classes and frequency. And in this, we have discrete series and continuous series. This you have done earlier, so I need not repeat it again in detail. So we'll be taking the calculation of arithmetic mean in all these three type of series: individual, discrete and continuous series. Okay, now here let us move to this part. There are two types of arithmetic mean. One is simple arithmetic mean and second is weighted arithmetic mean, right? Now first we'll be taking only simple arithmetic mean. This one, the first one we'll be taking now. And there are three methods of calculating simple arithmetic mean. What are these three methods? One is direct method, second shortcut method, and third is step deviation method. There are three methods. Now let us see calculation of arithmetic mean in individual series first, and then we'll be moving to discrete and continuous series. Now in case of individual series, as I told you earlier, individual items are given with no frequencies. So data are listed as they are observed. So whatever data is given, you have to note down all the data, get the total of value and divide this total by number of observations. How? It is clear here. Now by the direct method, in the case of individual series, first we'll apply the direct method, then shortcut method, then step deviation method. Now this is direct method. Now in this direct method, suppose marks scored by students are 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 and 65. This is a simple example I have taken to tell you the method of calculation. These are the marks scored by 6 students. Now how to calculate the arithmetic mean by direct method? You have to make two columns here. One, first column will be number of students and second column will be for marks. Number of students are not given over here, but you will count the number of items here and accordingly you will label it here, right? Marks are given because this is the case of individual series. Marks are given, so copy down the marks accordingly and name this column as X, right? So marks are noted down and students according to the number of items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now how to calculate the arithmetic mean? In the case of direct method, this is the formula for calculation of arithmetic mean. X bar is equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3, so on, xn upon n. Now what does this mean here? X1 is this, X2 is this, this is X3, X4, X5 and so on, and n is total number of items. Now in the compact form, we can say the formula X bar is equal to sigma x. Sigma means total, you know the symbol of sigma. Sigma means sum or the total. So sigma x means total of these upon n. This formula is the same as this one. This is the compact form of it. Now here in this case, whatever example we have taken over here, now the total sigma x is how much? This is 3, 1, 5 upon the number of items are 6. Now what we get here? This is 52.5. This is the arithmetic mean. We apply the formula and get the value placed here. Sigma x is this much, sigma total of x. This is sigma x. This is equal to 315 and number of item, total number of items are 6. So we have divided 315 by 6 and we get this value. This is known as arithmetic mean. That means average marks of these students whatever the figures are given here. How much? 52.5. Right? So this method is known as direct method. And here sigma x sum of all values, n is number of observations, x bar is equal to arithmetic mean. Clear? So this is the direct method of calculating arithmetic mean. And you have to learn the formula for direct method, right? And accordingly, when you know the formula, you have to make the columns. Immediately you know that what values you need for these two symbols, sigma x and n. So accordingly, you will do the calculation over here and place the values and get the mean, right? So this is one method, that is direct method of calculating arithmetic mean. Now we come to the next method. As I told you, there are three methods. Next one is shortcut method. Now, why do we need to have different methods? Reason is this, that if the number of items are not very large, right, and simple calculation is there, then you can apply the direct method. This is easier. But if the calculation is very large, it is in thousands, it has large figures, and if you go on adding up all the figures, that will be very difficult and time consuming. So for that reason, we have to apply some shortcut method, different method which is very short, shortcut method, so that the calculation becomes easier and there are no chance of errors also. Now, what is shortcut method here? First, we'll take the steps. Take an assumed mean and denote it as A. In a shortcut method, we have to assume certain mean, though we do not know what is actual mean that we'll be calculating. But we have to assume a certain figure as mean, and on the basis of that, we do the calculation. So first step is take an assumed mean and denote it as A. Take deviations for the items and take it as D, that is x minus A. Obtain the sum of these deviations, that is sigma D, and apply the formula x bar equal to A plus sigma D upon N. Now this is the formula for shortcut method, right? Now we will take the example and then we will be clear about the steps also. Calculate x bar from the given data. X bar is arithmetic mean. So calculate x bar means calculate arithmetic mean from the given data. This is the data given. It may be marks or whatever. So the data given here, 70, 65 and so on. Now you have to calculate the arithmetic mean. What is the average over here? Suppose you take it as marks. So you have to calculate what are the average marks over here. There are different figures given here. Now first step is take an assumed mean, right? You have to assume what can be the mean. How to assume? See the lowest figure over here. This is the lowest figure. And what is the highest figure? This one. In between, there will be the mean, which you don't know exactly. So take any figure which you assume as mean. Here, in our example, I have taken A as 80. This is assumed mean, right? Now, first you have to make the columns. Here, as the formula says, you need assumed mean, then you need sigma D, and then N. So that means you need assumed mean first step, and according to formula, you need D column, and then you need N, right? Now here serial number is given, because this is the case of individual series. X, what is X? The data what is given over here. This is X, this is labeled as X, this is the given data. And in the same order, you copy down the data here, right? Then next step is, take one assumed mean out of this data. We have taken as 80 as assumed mean, and then calculate the column, that is x minus a. That means x, what is x? X is here and a, this is a, right? X minus a, then you get d column. This d will be deviations. That means you have taken the deviations from the original values given. And how we have taken the deviations? Deviations from assumed mean. So here, in the first case, 70 minus 80. Why 80? Because 80 is the assumed mean. X is 70 here, and 70 minus 80 is equal to how much? Minus 10. Similarly, 65 is given here. 65 minus 80 is the assumed mean. 65 minus 80 is equal to minus 15. Similarly, 55 minus 80 is equal to minus 25. 75 minus 80 is equal to minus 5. 80 minus 80 is equal to 0. 85 minus 80 is equal to plus 5, right? Because 85 is bigger than 80. 85 minus 80 is plus 5. 65 minus 80 is again, this side is bigger, so minus 15. Then 70 minus 80 is minus 10. 95 minus 80 is equal to plus 15, because 95 is bigger than 80. So it is plus 15. Now, as your formula says, sigma d, so this is a d column. You have to add up these values, because you know you have to get sigma d. So add up all these values, minus separately and add up plus separately, and get the value, that is sigma d is here in this case is equal to minus 60. Clear? And this side x, you have to do the total. Sigma x is 660, right? Now, this, though you do not need the total of this column if you are doing it by shortcut method only. But here I have done the total of this column again just to show you that whether you apply the direct method or you apply the shortcut method, answer will be the same. See here, if you apply direct method, the formula says x bar is equal to sigma x upon n. Now sigma x is 660, n is how much? 9. So mean will get 73.33. Now if we apply the shortcut method, then we have different formula. And here a is 80 plus sigma d is minus 60, n is again 9. So 80 plus minus 60 upon 9, this will be 80 minus 6.687, and the answer will be 73.33. So here, when you are applying direct method or shortcut method, the answer is the same, right? It's only the calculation what you have to do. In this case, it is a simple calculation. We have added up these figures and I've shown you the direct method. But suppose the figures are very big over here in thousands, then it will be very difficult to add up all these figures. So in that case, it is better to take out the assumed mean and get the calculation done in this manner by applying the formula. And children, remember one thing: when you are applying the direct method, apply the correct formula only. This is the formula for direct method. When you are applying the shortcut method, apply this formula only. Don't get mixed up, right? Because mixing up the formula will give you the wrong calculation. For direct method, we have separate formula. For shortcut method, we have separate formula. Clear? And follow all the steps accordingly. And whenever you are putting the values, remember that first, always write down the formula, because if you write down the formula clearly, learn the formula properly, and if you write down the formula clearly and put the values accordingly, there is no chance of errors. And in the exam also, let me tell you, there are separate marks for writing down the formula. If you do not write the formula and do the calculation straight away, you will lose marks. So it is very necessary to be clear about the formula, write down the formula, and after writing down the formula, put the values at the right place and get the calculation done. Clear? Now, these two methods we have taken, direct method and shortcut method. Now, let us move to the third one. Which is the third one? Step deviation method. Now, this method I'll tell you. Step deviation method here. Now, this method is a little, you can say, expanded form of other two methods. The method of calculation is more or less the same. But if the figures are very large and the data is quite vast, in that case, step deviation method is used, in which the data is